In the huge office, a faint yellow light shone in from the window and cast a faint, soft shadow on the ground. The atmosphere was soaked with tension because of Mike's words. Jenna looked at Mike with a guarded expression, but met his burning eyes. She panicked and said in a tense voice, "If you have nothing else to say to me, I'm off work now." Mike's eyes darkened. She couldn't wait to leave because she wanted to get into Justin's arms as soon as possible. This woman was really ridiculous. How could she fall in love with Justin so quickly? "Are you really in love with Justin? Be honest. Are you sure you're really in love? Or is it just because he treats you well and pampers you?" Mike was unwilling to give up. He felt as stubborn as a child. Matters of love made him this way. However, the feeling of losing control also made him feel defeated. He had no control at all over his emotions. He knew he should let Jenna leave, but he couldn't stop questioning her. Jenna trembled slightly and raised her head in a daze. Her gaze lightly swept across his face and her voice was a low whisper. "Maybe. I don't know. This is my first time being in love. But he's all I think about. And I've never felt this way before." "Jenna, do you like him as a person, or do you just like his money?" Mike sneered. What right did this woman have to say she loved Justin? He really suspected that she was just in love with Justin's money. Jenna's eyes narrowed. Mike's questions were becoming more and more accusatory. She didn't know how to answer. So she did not answer. She remained silent. "Tell me, what should I do? What should I do to forget you?" Mike also knew he was being unreasonable. His mood suddenly dropped, and his gloomy eyes were full of pain. Jenna's heart tightened, and she subconsciously clenched her hands. Mike's wounded eyes made her very uneasy. "Don't be like this, Mike. You're one of the world's most eligible bachelors. It'll be so easy for you to find someone much better than me." Jenna tried to comfort him, but her words sounded hollow. "Do you know any women you could introduce to me?" Mike asked. Jenna couldn't tell if he was joking. It was a ridiculous question under the circumstances. Jenna did not know whether to laugh or cry. People said Mike was calm and mature, but around her, he always acted as unreasonable as a child. "Yes, actually. My friend Jessie. You can try going on a date with her. Don't you two already know each other?" Jenna blurted out. Mike's eyes darkened and stared at her coldly. "Don't you know the only reason I started working with Jessie was because I was angry with you?" Jenna was shocked again, and her beautiful eyes widened. "But didn't you give her a commercial? If you really don't have any interest in her, why do you keep giving her hope? Do you know my friend thought that you were being sincere?" Mike's handsome face was cold, and so was his voice. "It's my business who I treat well and why. It's not your place to tell me what to do." How could Jenna not be anxious and angry? Her tone became heavier. "If you really have no interest in my friend, please be honest with her. Don't let her get hurt after you've led her on like this." "Are you afraid?" Mike's lips curled up. He did not expect Jenna to be so loyal to her friend. "I just think you're being immoral. Since you don't really have feelings for her, don't set up a trap for her. She's a good girl. You'll break her heart." The more Jenna thought about it, the angrier she got. She was also anxious to the point that she could not take it anymore. If Jessie knew that all of this was just a trick Mike was playing to anger her, she would really be heartbroken. "All right, I'll find a time to talk to her, but I'm also going to tell her about things between us. What do you think?" Mike wanted to anger Jenna because she had also led him on and broken his heart. Seeing her anxious and uneasy made him feel very happy. Jenna's small face turned extremely pale. She could not help but be angry. "I really didn't think you were such a terrible person. If you really hurt my friend, I will definitely not let you off the hook." "Are you threatening me?" Mike saw that she was so angry that her small face had turned red. It made her look even more beautiful. It also made him want to keep prodding her. Jenna was so angry that her stomach and chest hurt. She hadn't realized what a bad person Mike really was. He was so bad, playing with Jesse's feelings, and even being so self-righteous about it. "That's right, I'm threatening you. Mike, I know you've killed people. If you don't stop playing with my friends, I might report you to the police." Jenna did not back off. She wanted to let Mike know that she was not easy to bully. "Would you really dare to do that?" Mike was stunned by her boldness. His handsome eyes stared at her and warned her. "Can you afford to find out?" Jenna also threw caution to the wind. When she thought about how Jesse would suffer, she did not care about anything else. "Don't think that I won't dare to do anything to you just because you're Justin's wife." Mike was angry and resentful. This woman was a lot tougher than he'd imagined. Jenna's heart beat quickly in her chest, but she straightened her body even more. She faced him squarely, even though she was much smaller than he was. "Didn't you assault me earlier?" "Mike, I don't like you. That clearly makes you upset. I've been in here for a long time. If you have the guts, go ahead and kill me now." Jenna's temper rose. Mike slowly inched toward her, towering over her. He stretched out his large palm and made a gesture to scare her. Jenna's body suddenly turned soft, and she fell to the floor in front of him. Jenna was still recovering from her fainting spell the day before. After working a full day, her body was exhausted. She'd overexerted herself too quickly. Mike's words and the surge of anger they'd caused in her had been the straw that broke the camel's back. When he lunged at her, she was overcome with dizziness and fell to the ground. Mike blinked down at Jenna's body in shock. His handsome face became anxious, and he quickly bent down to look at her. "Jenna, what are you pretending for? Wake up!" At first, Mike thought that Jenna was messing with him. He reached out and patted her face hard. His tone became harsh. "Jenna, get up! I'm warning you!" However, Jenna did not react at all. Her face remained pale, and her eyes were still tightly closed. "Wake up, Jenna! Are you really that afraid of me that I made you faint?" Mike didn't know Jenna had low blood pressure. She'd had it since childhood, and sometimes it caused her to faint, especially during periods of stress. The shock and grief of learning about her mother's death the day before, and now the shock of arguing with Mike today, was too much and had caused her to faint. Mike's brows tightly furrowed. In the next moment, he picked her up like a child and walked towards the sofa in his office. Mike set her body on the sofa and continued to prod at her, jiggling her arms and legs. "Jenna, I'm not joking with you. You better open your eyes for me. Otherwise, you will regret it." Mike's eyes softened as he looked at her. Her skin was smooth and clear, but a little too pale. Her pink lips had lost their previous luster, but they were still so full and soft that it made him want to taste them. Her long eyelashes rested against her cheeks like a feather fan. She looked so beautiful lying on his couch. Mike's breathing became heavy. He continued shaking her, but she still didn't wake up. Could it be that she had really fainted? Mike's heart beat quickly. He continued to slap her face with his fingers. "Jenna! Jenna! Don't joke with me! You can't faint in my office!" Unfortunately, Jenna still did not react at all. Her soft body looked limp and exhausted. Mike quickly stood up with his hands behind his back. His brows were tightly knitted. Suddenly, there was a knock on the door of his office. He heard his assistant Warren's voice. Mike gritted his teeth and walked over to open the door. Warren came in with some documents. He was shocked when he saw Jenna lying on the sofa unconscious.
"Sir, why is Mrs. Roy sleeping on your sofa? What is happening here?"
It was hard for Warren not to read into the situation. He looked at Mr. Jeffords in disbelief. He was shocked. Was something going on between him and Mrs. Roy? Mike threw a cold glance at him. He was extremely irritated.
It's not what it looks like. I just called her to the office to talk to her. I was a little strict, and then she just fainted. Then what should we do now? Is she all right? Warren was really worried for his boss. If Justin found out that his wife was lying in Mr. Jeffers' office, it would be a huge problem. Call Dr. Sherman over immediately. Call him now. Mike's heart suddenly started to beat rapidly. He rushed to the sofa in a hurry. He looked at Jenna's increasingly pale face and his tone became tense. What's wrong with her? Warren did not dare to delay a second. He called Dr. Sherman and asked him to rush over as quickly as possible. Mike picked up Jenna, who was on the sofa, and noticed that she was unbelievably light. He pushed open the door of the lounge and gently placed Jenna on the bed. Warren followed behind him and saw Jenna lying on the big bed that Sir usually rested on. He suddenly felt this wasn't a good image for the doctor to walk in on. Sir, I think it would be better to leave Mrs. Roy on the sofa. Mike gave him a look. I didn't ask for your opinion. At that moment, Jenna's phone began to ring. Her handbag, which she had been clutching the whole time, even while unconscious, slid out of her hand because of the phone's vibration and fell to the floor. Sir, what are we going to do? Mrs. Roy's phone is ringing. What if it's Mr. Roy? Warren immediately sounded the alarm, his face full of worry. Turn off that damn phone. Mike was extremely irritated. He was slightly worried this whole situation could cause problems between him and Justin. But at this moment, his greatest concern was the woman lying on the bed. Could her fainting have something to do with the pregnancy? Would she be all right? The phone's ringtone was extremely loud, which caused Warren's heart to palpitate even more in the already tense atmosphere. As Mike's right-hand man, Warren absolutely did not want to see anything go badly between him and Justin, especially not over a woman. If that happened, both their businesses would be in huge trouble, and the result would only be mutual destruction. Warren's trembling hands opened Jenna's handbag and found her phone, and when he pulled it out, he saw Justin's name flashing across the screen. Sir, it really is Mr. Roy calling, Warren said anxiously. Don't hang up yet. Let it ring. Mike's face darkened. He seemed suddenly calm. Warren quickly put Jenna's phone back into her handbag. He stood up and heard Mike closing the door of the lounge behind him. Sir? Warren felt his heart jump. Why was Mr. Jeffords closing the door? What was he going to do to Mrs. Roy? Warren was so nervous that his heart was in his throat. He really hoped that nothing bad would happen at this critical moment. Mike closed the lounge door behind him and walked lightly over to Jenna. He stood next to the bed and looked down at her. She looked like she was sleeping. Her breathing was light. It was extremely light. If he didn't listen carefully, he couldn't even hear it. Jenna, you better be okay. Do you hear me? Mike squatted by the bed and moved closer to her. His voice was heavy. However, the woman on the bed did not react at all, because she could not hear his worried voice. I promise you, I won't come after you anymore. Just wake up. Mike had closed the door tightly so Warren couldn't hear what he said. If you really love Justin that much, I'll quit. That's right. If he can really give you happiness. It's all your fault. Do you know that? You shouldn't have appeared in my life. What kind of woman do I want? I want you. Why can't I get you out of my mind? If you were with any other man, I would do whatever it took to snatch you away. But you had to be with Justin. I swore to him that I would never jeopardize our brotherhood because of a woman. But now, here you are. Isn't that ridiculous? Mike squatted by the bed. His eyes were focused on the sleeping woman. His deep voice was filled with sorrow. This kind of love was like fire. It could not be extinguished once it was ignited. It burned with a madness. He wanted to pull himself away from the fire, but it was too late. Outside the lounge, Warren braced himself and knocked on the door. "Sir, open the door. Dr. Sherman will be here soon."
Mike silently looked at the pale girl in front of him. He suddenly leaned over and kissed her soft cheek. Then he stood up and walked over to open the door. Warren stood outside the door with an embarrassed look on his face. He glanced at Jenna on the bed. She looked undisturbed.
"Sir, are you all right?"
Warren asked with concern. He had never seen Mike look so sad. He was shocked. Mike tiredly sat on the sofa and looked at the coffee table in front of him. However, it was as if he did not hear what Warren said. He was immersed in his own thoughts and could not come back to his senses for a long time. Warren sighed worriedly. It seemed Mr. Jeffers had really fallen hard for Jenna. Mike, who was once so proud and insufferably arrogant, had gone off the rails after falling in love. About 10 minutes later, Dr. Sherman, the Jeffords family's private doctor, knocked on the door anxiously and entered the room. There were beads of sweat on his forehead.
"What happened to Mr. Jeffords? Where is he? Let me see him."
The moment Dr. Sherman entered, he saw the tired Mike sitting on the sofa. He immediately walked over anxiously.
"Dr. Sherman, it isn't Mr. Jeffords who's sick," Warren quickly said.
"Not Mr. Jeffords? Then who is it?"
Dr. Sherman asked with a strange expression. In the past, when Mr. Jeffords had a headache and fever, he had personally come to see him. He thought that it was also Mike who had fallen sick this time. Mike stood up and walked to the lounge. Dr. Sherman followed him in. When he saw a woman lying on the bed, Dr. Sherman's expression immediately changed. He looked at Mike somewhat cautiously. It was hard for him to believe that Mr. Jeffords was seeing someone.
"She's pregnant. Take a look and see if her child is all right."
Mike's expression was anxious. Although he tried his best to suppress it, he couldn't.
"Pregnant?"
Dr. Sherman was shocked again.
"Let me take her pulse first. I'll be able to tell that way if the child is in danger," Dr. Sherman said confidently.
When he stretched out his hand to take Jenna's pulse, his eyes deliberately looked at Mike.
"Do you need a tissue or something?"
Mike's eyes darkened.
"Hurry up and check on her."
Dr. Sherman leaned over Jenna. Warren didn't understand why Mike's family kept Dr. Sherman around. He had always seemed a bit like a quack to him. He had such an odd personality and used strange methods. Dr. Sherman immediately put his hand on Jenna's wrist. He then felt her abdomen. He looked like he was concentrating deeply. Suddenly, his expression changed. He raised his head in disbelief and looked at the anxious Mike.
"Mr. Jeffords, are you sure this woman is pregnant?"
Dr. Sherman was confused. Mike had said with certainty that the woman was pregnant, but he saw no signs of pregnancy.
"Of course I'm sure. Otherwise, why would I be in such a hurry to find you?"
Mike's tone was heavy, and his handsome face became even more anxious. Dr. Sherman coughed dryly.
"Mr. Jeffords, forgive me for being blunt, but this woman is not pregnant at all. Her blood pressure is low, and she might be in shock, but there's no baby, and she'll be fine. I can wake her up right now."
Mike was completely stunned. He stared at Dr. Sherman and asked,
"Are you sure she's not pregnant?"
"I can guarantee with certainty that she is really not pregnant. I've extensively studied alternative medicine."
"Okay, that's enough of that. Just tell me, you're 100% sure she's really not pregnant?"
Warren knew that Dr. Sherman was very proud of his alternative medicine training. He had heard him talk about it countless times. Dr. Sherman nodded his head vigorously.
"Yes, I'm sure. She really isn't pregnant. I don't see any signs."
The corner of Mike's mouth suddenly curled upwards into a sinister smile.
"You just said that you could wake her up immediately. Let her wake up now."
Mike's expression suddenly became calm.
"Okay."
As Dr. Sherman spoke, he opened the medicine box he carried with him and took out a small bottle. He unscrewed the cap and placed it under Jenna's nose for a few seconds. Jenna began to cough a few times, then stirred. Her eyes fluttered open.
When she opened her eyes, she saw the faces of the three men above her. She cried out in shock.
"You're awake."
Mike pushed Dr. Sherman away and sat beside the bed. Jenna's head still felt very heavy. With one hand on her head, she said angrily,
"Mike, what did you do to me? What's that smell? It's so pungent."
Mike's tone changed from being cold and ruthless to warm and gentle. He said with a smile,
"You suddenly fainted just now. Don't you remember?"
Only then did Jenna recall what had happened. She vaguely remembered that what seemed like a few seconds ago, a wave of darkness suddenly came over her and she lost consciousness.
"I want to go home, right away."
Jenna saw the smile on Mike's face and felt a sense of danger. She struggled to get off the bed. Mike did not stop her and only asked with concern,
"Why is your body so weak? Is Justin not taking good enough care of you?"
When Dr. Sherman heard Mike's words, his whole body stiffened. Had he found out something that he shouldn't know? A cold sweat broke out on his forehead again. Considering Mr. Jeffords' character, would his life be in danger now that he had this information?
"Well, Mr. Jeffords, if there's nothing else, I'll be going now. I still have patients to see at my office."
Dr. Sherman didn't dare to stay any longer. The atmosphere here was too tense. He didn't want to see anything else he shouldn't. Mike nodded at him.
"Sorry to trouble you. Thank you for coming."
Dr. Sherman quickly left. Warren took the initiative to walk him to the door and said with a profound expression,
"Dr. Sherman, I'm sure you're aware it would be in your best interest to forget what happened today. Don't mention it to anyone."
"Sir, don't worry. I've worked with this family for a long time. I know how things work with them. I've kept many secrets."
Dr. Sherman replied with a smile. Warren nodded and let him go. Jenna had stood up from the bed and was also headed toward the door. When she saw her handbag fall to the ground, she rushed forward to pick it up. But when she bent down, she felt dizzy again.
"What happened to you? Did you forget how to take care of yourself since Justin always does everything for you now?"
Mike asked sarcastically from the side. Jenna glared at him angrily and wanted to pass out again.
"Mike, just stop it. My health is none of your business."
Mike's handsome face turned cold and he snorted,
"Well, you made it my business when you fainted in front of me. Next time, think about that before you collapse in my office."
"If you hadn't provoked me, would I have fainted?"
Jenna blamed him.
"All right. I promise you that I won't make you angry again. Hurry up and go downstairs. I'm afraid Justin has already come to find you."
Mike secretly heaved a sigh of relief. He was glad Justin hadn't barged into his office directly. Otherwise, things would have really been bad. Jenna's heart trembled when she heard Justin's name. Without saying anything more to Mike, she grabbed her bag off the ground and ran out the door. Mike gave Warren a look, and Warren followed her out anxiously. Jenna had been frightened by the unpleasant, pungent smell the doctor had used to wake her. She couldn't believe she had fainted in Mike's office. She pressed the elevator button hard and watched the elevator going up. Her expression was somewhat anxious and impatient. Just now, she had actually fainted in front of Mike. She was so disappointed. She hated that Mike had seen her like that. Maybe she would work on trying to prevent her fainting spells. The elevator door opened as Jenna looked at the floor, thinking about what had just happened. She was preoccupied, so she did not wait to see if there was anyone in the elevator and directly went in. In the next second, she ran straight into a man's embrace.
"What are you doing here?"
A familiar voice sounded above her head. Jenna was already panicking. When she suddenly heard Justin's voice, her whole body stiffened. She raised her head and bumped into a handsome and devilish face. The man looked at her with a surprised expression, as if he was investigating something.
Sir, Mrs. Roy was dropping off some documents for Mr. Jeffords."
Warren saw Justin suddenly appear in the elevator and was so scared that his hands shook.
He heard Justin's question and immediately rushed to answer him when Jenna faltered.
Why did you need her to bring it?
Justin casually asked, and the atmosphere became very stiff and heavy again. Warren looked at Jenna with a pleading look. Jenna quickly calmed down and said softly, "Our office assistant was out today. Mr. Jeffords really needed to sign the documents, so I delivered them myself." Justin wasn't too worried. Warren being there made him feel better. At least Jenna hadn't been alone with Mike.
"Mike is in the office?" Justin asked Warren.
"Yes, he's just about to leave. Mr. Roy, do you want to come in and have a seat?"
Justin asked respectfully.
Justin shook his head. "No need. I still have things to do."
After saying that, he pressed the button and the elevator door instantly closed. Only after the elevator doors closed did Jenna remember that she was still in Justin's embrace. Her mind went blank for a second. Her body relaxed, and there was a look of contentment on her face. Justin held her tightly in his arms.
"Why didn't you call me and tell me you were getting off work late?"
Jenna heard the man's slightly dissatisfied voice next to her ear. She wasn't in the mood to argue. She still felt a little dizzy, and her head felt swollen. Leaning in his embrace, she was completely safe.
"Justin, did you ask Lance to come find me today?"
"He asked me about some details about our wedding," Jenna whispered.
"He told me you were trying to save us some money."
Justin's deep voice carried a hint of a smile. Jenna was embarrassed. She said,
"I just feel that the budget is too high. Are we sure we want to use this planning agency? They seem expensive."
"Yeah, they love clients like us. The more money you have, the more they'll find ways to charge you."
Justin sneered in disdain.
"Then why did you agree to work with them even though you knew they were like that?" Jenna muttered.
Justin stretched out his hand and flicked her face.
"Because I don't want to make things difficult for you."
Jenna's eyes instantly became moist. The elevator door opened on the ground floor, revealing large crowds of employees leaving Crown for the day. Jenna quickly held back her tears. Justin noticed that she did not reply for a long time. He looked down and saw that her eyes were red and her lips were pulled taut. With just one sentence, she was so moved that she couldn't speak. Justin let go of Jenna and they walked together into the hall. Not long after he walked out of the elevator, a gentle female voice suddenly rang out and shouted with a smile,
"Mr. Roy, long time no see."
Justin looked to the side and saw a young, familiar face. It was Claire. She looked like she had just come back from a banquet. She wore a formal dress and her makeup was exquisite and perfect. Coupled with her pair of beautiful, expressive eyes, she looked indescribably charming.
"What do you want?"
Justin asked faintly, meeting Claire's enthusiasm with a tone like an icy rain. The smile on her face froze, but she still tried to be as gentle as possible and said,
"Nothing much. It's just that I haven't seen you in a long time. I'm happy to have run into you."
When Claire said the word happy, her big, bright eyes deliberately met his. Justin, however, indifferently swept his gaze across her face. His tone was polite and distant.
"Sorry, I don't have time to catch up right now. My wife and I have a busy evening."
As he spoke, Justin took Jenna's hand in his. He led her outside to the parking lot. Justin's attitude toward Claire went from an icy rain to a blizzard. Passersby saw the embarrassment come over Claire's proud face.
"Claire, let me hold up your skirt for you. You'll fall if you walk like that,"
Claire's assistant said in a trembling voice. Claire's face lost its luster at Justin's rejection. Naturally, she was in a bad mood. She angrily told her assistant,
"Get lost. Don't bother me."
However, just as she was finished scolding the assistant, she tripped on the dragging skirt and fell to the ground.
"You're useless. Do you want to be fired? When you see me fall, help me up."
Claire got up angrily and threw the high heels on her feet at the assistant's face. Barefooted, she walked towards the elevator. By now, Jenna and Justin were already in the car, about to pull out of the Crown office parking lot. Jenna turned her head as the car began to drive off, and she just happened to see Claire throwing a tantrum and yelling at the assistant in front of everyone. Justin only glanced at her lightly and sneered, "Is this the type of woman Mike likes? I don't understand his taste." Jenna was slightly stunned. Did Justin not know what the relationship between Claire and Mike actually was?
"Claire's the biggest celebrity I've met at work. She's such a talented actor. It really is a shame about her personality."
The real Claire was nothing like the character she played on TV. Justin didn't want to talk about Claire anymore. He pulled out of the parking lot and sped home. In the office of the top floor of the Crown Entertainment building, Mike was lying on the sofa with his long legs crossed. He was feeling a lot of things and didn't know if they were good or bad, but it was better than feeling numb. Justin had actually lied to his grandfather about Jenna's pregnancy. It was too much. How could he be so brazen? Mike thought about all the times he'd met Mr. Roy. He was cunning and smart. It was hard to imagine him being deceived by his own grandson. Mike wondered how angry he would be if he knew the truth. Warren was standing beside him. When he saw the expression on Mr. Jeffords' face, he was stunned.
"Sir, aren't you worried that Mrs. Roy will tell Mr. Roy about what happened? Or make up some other story to tell him?"
Warren was extremely worried. Mike smiled confidently.
"Of course I'm not worried. She's not gonna tell him. It wouldn't be a good look for her either. She's not stupid."
"What do you mean?" Warren widened his eyes in shock. Mike stood up with a smile on his face.
"She's not stupid, but she's stupid enough to fall in love with Justin."
"What do you mean?" Warren asked. Mike snorted.
"She really shouldn't be with him. And if I have anything to say about it, they won't be together for long."
"You really want Mr. Roy to get a divorce?" Warren asked carefully.
Mike's eyes looked serious. He said self-deprecatingly,
"Do you think that's too much?"
Warren shook his head hard.
"Forgive me. I just don't want to see a woman come between you and Mr. Roy. Together, you are invincible. I want to see you stay that way. Is it really worth it to let a woman jeopardize that?"
"Enough. Stop talking."
Mike's face was covered with a layer of frost, and his expression was cold. Warren quickly kept quiet, but he really hoped Mr. Roy would listen to his warning. Justin drove Jenna back to the Roy's mansion. The atmosphere between them was light, and they were talking about the wedding. In the past, Jenna would have thought that a busy man like Justin would not care about wedding details, but during their conversation, she realized that he was considering them even more thoroughly than she was.
"Get out of the car. I want to show you something."
Justin opened the car door and got out. Jenna's heart was moved. Justin seemed to be very anxious to grab her hand and take her up the stairs. When they got to the second floor, he pushed open the door to the guest room. Suddenly, a dazzling, pure white wedding dress appeared in front of her.
"So beautiful," Jenna subconsciously muttered.
She had thought that the wedding dress Liz had worn was the most beautiful wedding dress she had ever seen. But this wedding dress in front of her was even more beautiful.
"Do you like it?"
Justin wrapped his arms around her from behind and stared at the wedding dress in admiration.
"I like it."
Jenna was embarrassed by her dazed look and softly said,
"Where did you buy this?"
"I didn't just buy it at a store. It was specially customized and is completely unique. It's the only one like it that exists in the world."
Justin gently turned her around to face him and stared at her with tears in his eyes. His voice was deep and charming.
"You are irreplaceable to me, Jenna."
Jenna's eyes became moist again. It was strange. Why did he make her cry so easily?
"Justin, I have never been with a man like you."
Jenna's tears rolled down from the corners of her eyes. She reached out to wipe them off, but more and more began to fall.
The feeling of being wronged lingered in her heart, but it dissipated because of the man in front of her.
"Don't cry. Go and try it on."
Justin reached out his hand to wipe away her tears. The corners of his mouth lifted up, and his smile was extremely gentle. Joy replaced sadness. Jenna sniffed and stopped crying. She wanted to try on this elegant and stunning wedding dress.
Jenna put on the wedding dress shyly and reached for the zipper behind her. Jenna turned her head, but she could not see the scar on her shoulder from this angle. "My grandmother said that I was injured when I was born. I don't know how it happened, though." Jenna sighed lightly. A warm sensation suddenly came from the scar. Jenna's body tensed up as she felt Justin's lips on it. In the next moment, an electric current spread from the man's lips to her heart. She subconsciously grabbed onto the fabric of the dress. Justin continued to kiss her neck. In front of her was a huge mirror. Jenna could see the desire in Justin's eyes, and her heart was beating wildly. Her eyes were filled with charm. She barely recognized her own reflection. She couldn't believe she was wearing a beautiful white wedding dress. She was as beautiful as an elf in the dark, an image that enchanted Justin. Jenna lightly pulled back and asked Justin, "Does it look good?"
"Yes, but you'll look even better not wearing it." There was a mischievous light in Justin's eyes. Jenna was slightly stunned. In the next moment, Justin gently pulled the zipper down her back. The zipper was of good quality, and the sound it made was very soft. Jenna's body tingled as she felt it slide down her spine. Once the dress was completely unzipped, Justin let go of the fabric, and the wedding dress fell to the ground. Jenna stood in front of him in just her underwear. At this moment, she felt no embarrassment. It was like the dress had enchanted her too. Justin's eyes seemed to glow as he looked at her. As it was not night yet, it was only dusk. The sound of the maids walking around downstairs could occasionally be heard, as could Quince's voice as he instructed them. Jenna's mind was blank. Her body felt light, like she could be blown away by the gentlest wind. Justin picked her up and carried her to the bed. When they were finished, he looked at her across from him on the bed. His devilishly handsome face was filled with satisfaction. "This guest room doesn't have a bathroom. We have to go back to our bedroom." Justin looked at the ruffled sheets and then looked at Jenna with a charming smile. Without raising her head, Jenna whispered under the blanket, "You go first. I'll just lay here for a while." Only then did Justin casually turn over and get out of bed. He picked up his shirt and pants and casually put them on before walking to the bathroom. Jenna peeked out from under the covers to watch him. As she watched the man lightly closing the door, the corners of her mouth could not help but raise into a smile. The feelings he gave her simply made her soul tremble. Justin had given her an unforgettable memory time and time again. How could she not be addicted to this man? Jenna stayed in bed for a while longer. After more than 10 minutes, she got up, put on her clothes, and returned to their bedroom. As she entered the room, Justin came out of the bathroom with a white towel wrapped around his waist. His perfect, statuesque body made Jenna's breath catch in her throat. She felt a feeling like an electric pulse travel through her body. There was something about sleeping with him in the guest room that had made it even more exciting. She was slightly embarrassed and averted her eyes. Justin looked at her with a smile and said, "Isn't it fun to change things up?" It was like he had read Jenna's mind. She blushed and scampered into the bathroom. After taking a shower, Jenna came back into the bedroom and found that Justin wasn't there. She started walking down the stairs and heard him talking to Quince. "The day before the wedding, my grandfather will be staying here. Clean up the north side of the courtyard and let him stay in the room that overlooks it," Justin whispered to Quince. When Jenna heard Justin's words, she was so surprised she paused on the stairs. Would Justin's grandfather come to the wedding? She did not know why,
but that made her feel very nervous and uneasy. Even though the last time Mr. Roy had invited Justin to visit him, he hadn't said anything about her, she was still worried. She knew she wasn't welcomed in the Roy family. Justin's grandfather wasn't happy about their marriage. There was another thing that made Jenna even more uneasy. The fact that Justin had lied to his grandfather about her being pregnant. She and Justin had been trying to get pregnant for a few days, but who knew if there would be good news next month? Unconsciously, she tightened her grip on the railing of the stairs, and her heart was in chaos. She suddenly realized that at this moment, in her mind, she actually hoped that she would get pregnant quickly. She did not want Justin to have an unhappy relationship with his grandfather. And if that was what it took to get her accepted by the family, she was okay with it. Besides, she wanted to have a child with him now that they were really in love. She laughed internally, thinking about how much she hadn't wanted it before. Sure enough, love changed everything. Recently, a baby had been the last thing she wanted, but now she was in a hurry to get pregnant. It was funny how things turned out sometimes. Justin heard light footsteps behind him. He looked back and saw Jenna coming down the stairs. She wore a soft, apricot-colored dress, and her long hair hung loosely at her shoulders. She looked simply beautiful. The light material of her clothes revealed her beautiful curves as she walked. Justin suddenly wanted her again. His vision blurred, and he felt dizzy with desire. He felt that he must be going crazy. How could he love this woman so much? "Justin, I just heard you say that your grandfather is coming to our wedding. Is that true?" Jenna asked softly. Justin nodded. "Yes, this time he promised to attend our wedding." "But last time, he didn't appear." Jenna's heart was uneasy, and her beautiful eyes flickered as she spoke. Justin's face darkened slightly. "I invited him last time, but he refused to come because he was feeling unwell." Quinn smiled and said, "Mrs. Roy, this is very good news. Mr. Roy Sr. agreeing to come to your wedding is equivalent to him acknowledging your marriage with Mrs. Roy." Jenna's beautiful eyes glanced at Justin. She also felt a little depressed when she saw Justin's expression. "Quince, there's one more thing." Justin suddenly spoke with a heavy tone. Quince was stunned and immediately said, "What is it, Mr. Roy? Tell me." "The last time I went to visit my grandfather, I told him Jenna was pregnant. When my grandfather asks about it, just tell him that it's true," Justin said in a deep voice. Quince was shocked. "Mr. Roy, how can you lie like that? To your grandfather, no less." "I had to do it to save my marriage. It's only temporarily a lie. Hopefully she'll become pregnant soon and he won't suspect a thing. It'll be like I never lied. My grandfather was trying to meddle in our marriage, but you know me. I can't be controlled by others. I have to do whatever it takes. This is my own marriage, and I should be the only one who has a say in it." Justin's expression changed. He became cold when he talked about this. He couldn't help it. Quince let out a bitter sigh. "Mr. Roy, I understand. Don't worry. For the sake of your and Mrs. Roy's happy marriage, I'll help you with this." "Thank you, Quince." Justin smiled gratefully at him. He turned around and grabbed Jenna's small hand. "Let's go outside and relax. Fresh air will be good for the baby." Justin winked. Jenna nodded and followed him out of the hall. The Roy's property covered a vast area, but only 2/3 of it had been developed. The remaining 1/3 was covered in forest. A thick growth of trees surrounded the mansion in a semicircle. The parts of the grounds that had been developed were like a beautiful park. There was a meticulously maintained garden that was planted with the most beautiful flowers and trees during the warmer seasons. The two of them walked forward slowly through the lush greenery. The dark night sky was illuminated by warm lamps that adorned the property. The wind was gentle and cool in the night, and there was an indescribable tranquility to the air. Jenna leaned in Justin's arms and listened to his strong heartbeat, but her heart was still somewhat uneasy. "Justin, if your grandfather knew that I wasn't pregnant, how angry would he be?" Jenna finally could not help but ask. Justin's lips curled into a smile. "Don't worry, everything will be okay. Dr. Klein has already told me that if you're still not pregnant in 2 months, he'll make some records saying you've lost the pregnancy. And if that happens, my grandfather will definitely stop trying to interfere with our marriage." Justin's words were like a calming balm. Jenna's uneasy heart quickly calmed down. "I only hope that our wedding goes completely smoothly." Jenna's heart was full of anticipation. She could not help but reveal a sweet smile. Love could make one's head spin. At this moment, Jenna's heart was like a blooming flower. Justin lowered his head and looked at her. His mind was also spinning. "No one can stop me from marrying you. I'll handle everything." He held her face in his hand tenderly. Justin's handsome face was full of love for her. Jenna felt that her heart was about to melt from this man's tenderness. She leaned against him and hugged him tighter and tighter. "Okay, then I'll stop worrying." The Roy's wedding invitations were sent out, and naturally, the Windsors were on the guest list. Philip's face darkened as he held the invitation. He threw it onto the table and said,
"Justin, do you think that you haven't already embarrassed our family enough? He's kicking us while we're down."
Erica reached out and took a look at the card. Her face was red with anger and her tone was aggrieved.
"My Liz's life is really miserable. The last wedding was such a disaster. Imagine what it would be like for Liz to be a guest at this one. She'll be a laughingstock."
Augustus was silent, but the unhappiness in his heart was written all over his face. Liz had recently gone to work on a film, and the director had been very pleased with her acting. "Liz is not a child in her room anymore. She is a celebrity now. This scandal is going to spread and affect all of us. Everyone will know about it. It won't only be our family and friends. The whole country will be talking about it. And it's all because of that woman." Erica felt extremely wronged. She wiped away her tears and cried for her daughter's injustice. She was trying to show Philip how vicious Jenna's heart was and how shameful her actions were. Philip was even more annoyed. He slammed his fist down on the table and said,
"The Roys have gone too far."
Augustus seemed to have seen through the real reason why his wife was crying. He said in an irritated tone,
"Enough. Stop that crying. This was surely Justin's idea. Jenna doesn't have enough status in the Roy family to make something like this happen."
"No status? How is that possible? She's Justin's wife. I don't know what kind of scheme she's planning here, making Justin spend all this money on another wedding. We have really underestimated her."
Erica was still brooding over Jenna snatching away her daughter's husband. Nothing could change her mind about Jenna's character. Philip's expression softened a little, and he said with a solemn face,
"All right. I know Liz was very hurt by Justin, but Jenna has also helped out the Windsors a lot during her time as Justin's wife. And she didn't have a say in the matter. This marriage was necessary for our family to be able to continue working with Justin. All of you should put your feelings aside. When you see Jenna in the future, don't let her see how you really feel."
Erica regretted saying too much. She knew her father-in-law's top priority was business, and that's how he saw the marriage between Jenna and Justin.
"I know that,"
Erica quickly replied in a low voice, afraid that her father-in-law would be angry at her for her display of contempt towards Jenna. The Powells had also received a wedding invitation, and the atmosphere in the entire family became gloomy and heavy. Mrs. Powell stared blankly at the invitation and was so angry that she couldn't think clearly. She held her cane and was about to go throw the invitation in the trash.
"Grandma, don't be angry. It's not good for your health."
Jacqueline patted her grandma's hand and tried to comfort her. Amanda sat on the sofa with a look of anger on her face, but her heart wasn't really in the matter at hand. A plan was forming in her mind. In the past, she'd often felt heartache from losing her daughter, and now that she had a chance of finding her, she was thinking in different terms. She was thinking that if she really did find her, her daughter could marry into the Jeffords family. Whether it was the Roys or the Jeffords, as long as her daughter could marry into one of those families, it would be very helpful in safeguarding the long-term success of the Powells. Unfortunately, all she'd learned from Nurse Isabel was that there was a birthmark or a scar on the back of her daughter's shoulder. She didn't even know if it was her left shoulder or her right. How could Mrs. Powell not be angry? She was so angry that she wanted to use her walking stick to hit someone.
"This son of the Roys is too much. I can't believe he's having another wedding. This just adds insult to injury for us, Jacqueline. You poor thing. Just wait. Even if this is the death of me, I'll come back to haunt that boy."
Mrs. Powell hugged her granddaughter and sobbed. When Jacqueline heard this, she was immediately shocked and quickly patted her grandmother's back to help her breathe.
"Grandma, don't speak nonsense. I want you to live a long life. Justin has let me down, and I also hate him. But the one who deserves to die is Jenna. If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have become a laughingstock."
Amanda was so angry that she did not want to speak, but hearing her daughter's sad words, she tried to comfort her.
"Jacqueline, I know that you've been wronged, but we can't act rashly on this matter. Jenna is pregnant, and Mr. Roy Sr. hasn't spoken out against the wedding. So we have to agree to it, too. We can't cause any trouble. Think about it. Your father is the vice president, and if we cause a ruckus, we are afraid that Crown Entertainment will turn around and do business with your father's competitor. This wedding could cause huge problems for us, or it could barely change anything. The way this whole thing affects us will depend on how we react."
Mrs. Powell didn't like Amanda's calm attitude. As soon as her son had said he wanted to marry Amanda, she had a suspicion that she was scheming. She was trying to persuade her son to leave this woman, but she was helpless. Her son doted on his wife and clearly loved her. Jacqueline also had her mother's calm side. After being repeatedly defeated, she gradually backed down.
"Mom, 10 years isn't too late for me to take revenge. Jenna doesn't have any power without Justin. If Justin suddenly didn't want her anymore, she would be nothing. But that's not true for me. My father is the vice president. I already have power and connections. I have time to wait."
A cold smile hung at the corner of Jacqueline's mouth, and her eyes were filled with hatred. Amanda thought her daughter made good points. She was proud of her conviction. Mrs. Powell snorted and turned around to walk upstairs. Jacqueline picked up the wedding invitation that was embossed with gold and could not hide the jealousy on her face. When she opened it, she felt a surge of anger. Jacqueline threw it away and tears ran down her face. Why did Justin feel the need to humiliate her all over again? Mike had just woken up. He took a shower, changed his clothes, and prepared to go downstairs to eat breakfast. Just as he got downstairs, he heard his parents discussing something.
"Justin is really bold. I can't believe he's decided to hold a second wedding. I really admire his boldness. That's how young men should be,"
Mike's father, Frank, said while eating his breakfast. His mother laughed mockingly.
"That's right. You've always said that you admired Justin, but you never say that about your own son. But our son has also become a great man. You should stop being so hard on him."
As soon as his wife said this, Frank's demeanor changed.
"So what if I'm hard on him? He's my son. I have to be hard on him to raise him well. I can't let him get arrogant. Justin has been disciplined since he was young, and he is a born leader. Our son isn't as disciplined."
Mike had been compared to Justin by his parents since he was young.
He had already grown up, yet they were still comparing them. He knew that in his father's eyes, he had always been the loser of the unofficial competition between them.
Dad, if you really like Justin so much, just acknowledge him as your godson.
Mike coolly pulled out a chair and sat down. When his mother saw her son's dark expression, she hurriedly pushed a glass of milk in front of him.
Don't talk nonsense so early in the morning. Quickly eat breakfast.
What were you guys talking about just now? Whose wedding invitation is this?
Mike drank the milk and reached for the wedding invitation. When he opened it, the hand holding the milk suddenly froze, and the cup he was holding trembled.
Justin and Jenna are going to hold the second wedding?
Mike's pupils suddenly shrank, and his handsome face was covered with a layer of frost. His skin looked ashen. Mrs. Jeffords did not notice the stiff look in her son's eyes. She just casually said,
"The wedding last time was very unpleasant. Maybe Justin wants to apologize to his wife."
"Yes, this is the attitude that a successful person should have. I would expect no less from him. I've heard that Justin dotes on his new wife very much," Frank said with a smile.
When Mike heard his father say this, he threw a disdainful look at him. His voice was also a little cold.
"Dad, do you really think that being loyal to your wife is how a man should be?"
Frank was stunned and then nodded.
"Of course. Didn't I teach you that since you were young?"
Mike's mouth twitched.
"Let me ask you, is that how you treat my mother? You're telling me that for all these years, you've never seen any women on the side."
Mike's mother's expression instantly changed. Her gaze was sharp as she looked at her husband. Frank's expression froze for a moment. Then he frowned and said,
"What do you mean by that? Why would I have other women on the side?"
"Can you promise me that you don't have any?" Mike didn't know what made him lash out this way, but he couldn't stop himself. When he'd heard his father praising Justin, something had snapped in his heart. Frank stopped eating, and his face immediately became serious.
"I didn't do anything to let your mother down. I can promise you that."
Mike suddenly stood up, accidentally knocking over the glass of milk with his arm. The milk spilled on the table and dripped onto the ground.